around you are spirits, child. They live in the earth, the water, the sky. If you listen, they will guide you.
I hear the wind.
Yes. What is it telling you?
I don't understand.
Ancestral guides are a carefully selected and recruited group of beings whom have bloodline connections to us and our interstellar historical lineages, whom are devoted to our soul's evolution and our conquest in this system of speciesism and spiritual genetic war. Providing assistance from the sanctuary of the astral realm dimension, as well as other contexts of existence, these appointed specialists, advisors, and divine protectors surround our energy fields, sharing profound insight and sacred knowledge, offering immediate comfort, tranquility, reassurance, clarity, and support in overcoming genealogical traumas and mental programming by giving us emotional courage and invigorating our souls. True starseeds and energy sensitives recognize that although we may personally feel a close connection with certain tribal groups, species, and homeworlds that we have had the honor of experiencing over the course of our past lifetime campaigns, in supreme actuality, we children of the cosmos are from everywhere that we have ever been, and we are from everywhere that we have never been. So our spirit allies both exist and can appear to us in an unlimited amount of shapes and countless humanoid forms. Ancestral guides are our soul tribe from the other side of the veil, which can include, but are by no means limited to, relatives and loved ones that have transitioned from their physical material avatars to the spirit world, elevated souls, ascended masters, gods and goddesses from many different pantheons, cosmic entities, magical guardians, archangelic and other celestial beings, extraterrestrial, as well as intraterrestrial Earthseed species, for example, such as the various Sanguinean, Elven, and aquatic tribes, as well as members of the Republic of the Fae. With the stability and strength of ancient wisdom, the infinite presence of our ancestors illuminate pathways that assist us in effortlessly navigating through this matrix in order to fulfill our mission and accomplish our assignment while here on our sister Earth in dismantling this sentient world simulation, helping we divine beings in working through the inherited multi-generational traumas and the breaking of bloodline curses, opening our minds and our hearts to all of the thermodynamic miracles that are constantly and continuously unfolding before us, activating and upgrading our DNA in preparation for upcoming paradigm shifts that accompany this dawning of a new era, and in releasing old energetic blockages that can threaten to keep us permanently embedded in low vibrational attachments and constricted states of being.
Reminds me of Turkum, my mother's brother. Sort of the family misfit. Everybody told me to stay away from him. Bad influence.
Did you?
Are you kidding? He's the only member of my family who had a sense of humor. Except no one ever stayed around him long enough to realize it but me. My mother tells me I remind her of him, and I probably do. The idea of fitting in just repels me.
Every conflict that is fought is a conflict that should have never began in the first place. When it comes to the battle space of this system of speciesism and spiritual genetic war, being waged within the social-political imaginary of this educational artificial reality training habitat, a violent atmosphere where ideals and loyalties are always being put to the test. Our ancestral guides play absolutely no games with regards to defending and protecting us, nor do they engage in any activities with our adversaries for the purposes of amusement, enjoyment, nor recreation. As patrons of spiritual law and omniversal principles of truth, our ancestral guides are by no means mere gentle chaperones, nor are they non-violent pacifists. Rather, they are ferocious guardians and enforcers, as well as avenging angels of justice. As both we eternal warriors and our ancestral guides all understand the necessity of meeting aggression with defense, and at times, accordingly answering that aggression with aggression whenever it is deserved. Working with both light and dark forces from the upper and lower realms, ancestral guides assist us in mounting an armed resistance against the belligerent conduct and spiritual warfare attacks carried out against we divine beings that seek to target our psychic intuition and our supernatural instincts in order to prevent our soul's evolution and ascension, while also helping us in shutting down all high malevolent psychological operations, astral witchcraft and physical spell work, energy disruptive technology, and other matrix diversionary tactics that threaten to alter our perceptions based on the illusory projections of this third dimensional realm. Our ancestral special forces are unapologetically authentic and are utterly ruthless in battle. Calling in ethereal judgment on those whom try to neutralize and eliminate our bloodlines here on our sister Earth by causing chaos and interference within our auric field, diminishing the glow of our energetic signatures, and removing us from our physical bodies, our spirit team exact precise and severe punishment on anyone in our opposition for their unjust pursuits, as they bring unimaginable pain, destruction, and devastation in the lives of our adversaries, ensuring that our enemies will never recover from the degrading and inhumane treatment that they have committed against us during our lifetime campaigns, holding these defilers accountable for the unlawful offenses and spiritually criminal abuses that they have committed in pathetic attempts to cause us suffering in order to validate themselves and their own status. Escorting our adversaries and their toxic enablers directly to an early grave.
Because it's kind of, ew, like, just think about the people that you have beef with and you survive. And you have no, like, scars from it.
It's none. None.
It's nothing.
It's nothing.
Digital dehumanization is a process where sentient beings are reduced to electronic data that is collected and stored on programmable operating machines for technological and educational research, which are then used by the controllers of this matrix to energetically sabotage, to misguide, and to influence individuals to make decisions and or to take actions that negatively affects their lives. In order to protect the predestined plan for our lifetime campaigns, ancestral guides monitor starseeds through direct interaction and communication without the use of any intermediaries, providing we divine beings with revelations, insight, and supervision for accomplishing the prime directives of our special assignments while here on our sister Earth. Intervening and conveying celestial messages and instructions for us through signs, symbols, repetitive numerical sequences, sacred geometric patterns, musical compositions, animals, inner visions, psychic downloads, past life memories, dreamtime dimensional visits, and synchronicities that assist us in the development of spiritual awareness so that we are able to view beyond the web of lies, false storylines, third-dimensional excuse-based mechanisms, and outdated belief systems, so that we courageously defy social political constraints and surrender neuropsychological dependence to the romanticized illusions of this educational artificial reality training habitat. We ourselves have the honor of having been selected to continue the legacy of galactic beings as keepers of ancient wisdom while here on special visitation. And our ancestral guides are sacred travelers and co-creators, heavily urging and reminding us in these transformative times to listen closely to our psychic intuition, to place our focus on our boundless potential, and to always remain optimistic, keeping in mind that our spirit team are always walking beside us, giving us hope, safety, and a place of belonging, while aiding us in the advancement of our divine gifts and special abilities, as well as in mastering manifestation energy with crystal pure intentions, so that we effectively seize opportunities that are important for our journey, paving ways to march even further down the road on our quest of remembrance towards true abundance.
Man, I'm so hyped right now. Anything's possible. Anything's possible!
Spiritual authenticity is the way to enjoy true superabundance of the intergalactic soul, as well as an overflowing fullness of personal growth experience. Ancestral guides exponentially help we source code beings to transcend morality and move into alignment by healing the spirit-dampening illusion of separation and duality, expanding our visions beyond self-imposed limitations to further our introspection and systems thinking observational abilities in order to perform at our highest levels by activating our DNA to reach our full potential that is induced through exposure to exotic energies, motivating us to embrace the magnificence of our absolute power and eternal connection to the omniversal network environment as villainized evolutionaries unyieldingly determined to defy compound aggravations and to actively oppose the interests of this authoritarian power structure and dynamic.
I never wanted this for you. I worked my whole life. I don't apologize to take care of my family. And I refused to be a fool. dancing on the string, held by all those big shots. I don't apologize, that's my life, but I thought that when it was your time, that you would be the one to hold the strings. This wasn't enough time, Michael. It wasn't enough time.
We'll get there, Pop. We'll get there.
It's the rainy season.
Source code beings are trees of everlasting life, and our ancestral guides are the roots that reach deep into the earth and throughout the space-time continuum, connecting us to the very beginning, to all of life, and to the wholeness of the cosmos. The soulful bonds with our spirit team are the threads that weave us into internal exploration of new ideas, so that we embrace aspects of the creative mind and bring forth into existence all that we desire to manifest in the direction of our divine will. As omniversal transmitters and communicators, we ourselves are the representatives of higher consciousness that our bloodlines have been patiently awaiting for the arrival of. Ancestral guides represent adaptation to survive and to thrive in any and all conditions of this gruesome spiritual genetic war, reminding we eternal warriors that our lifetime campaigns are never defined by tragedy. Just as steel is tempered by the fire to be shaped into a mighty sword, rising above trial and tribulation, balance, trusting in your own psionic and psychokinetic special abilities, evolution of the soul, as well as living in harmony with spiritual law and omniversal principles of truth, is only achieved through challenges and adversity.
The great British explorer George Mallory, who was to die on Mount Everest, was asked why did he want to climb it. He said, because it is there. Well, space is there, and we're going to climb it. And the moon and the planets are there, and new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Having multiple incredible and immersive lifetimes of adventures across the galaxy as eternal warriors and evolutionary caretakers of celestial bodies, many of us were chosen for this lifetime campaign to walk with our sister Earth as carriers of ancient knowledge and wisdom of experience. We ourselves, in these physical material bodies, in this third dimensional realm, within this context of existence, even with all of our challenges, are the living embodiment of divine justice and divine purpose, as well as the living embodiment of our galactic lineage and ancestral legacy that we have inherited. Our divine gifts of the supernatural variety, special abilities of omniphysics manipulation and quantum modification once expressed by loved ones of the distant past, are well beyond the comprehension of religionists and scientists. As source code beings, we ourselves are the endgame, the bridge between worlds unique to nature for thousands of years, weapons forged in the fires of revelation, symbolic representatives of the highest goals and ideals, infinitely adaptive harbingers of change, and divine messengers of all six directions, carrying eons of cosmic intelligence provided with the necessary context to envision even further than the mechanistic ways of Earth-based interpretation and analyzation of information, allowing us to expand our consciousness and to break free from advanced technological restraints, lower-level perspectives, human-centric design, external threats such as the confusing toxicity of diverging ideologies, neurotechnology, implantable brain-computer interfaces, sentient artificial intelligence through the use of lethal autonomous robotic weapon systems, and bigotry, which takes the form of civil, religious, and governmental legislative actions against celestial beings. Our supervillainy in the face of speciesism and oppression, defined by our radical actions taken as a matter of adherence to omniversal principles, our everlasting empathic and generous spirit, inspiring resilience, and inner strength that accompanies overcoming our deepest fears as righteous defenders in dismantling this world's insatiably cruel individuals and private organizations whom are engaged in inclinations towards evil, secret intrigues, and secret agendas, taking pleasure to work their malice deliberately inflicting harm onto brave awakened ones, assist us in experiencing radiant success in developing effective communication with the Astral Realm Dimension, restoring timeline dissonance, rekindling ancient starseed arts, and architecturally rewriting the codes of awareness as authority over the dominant frequencies of this third dimensional realm is our birthright. So with concentration on our future and beyond, our undying passion about staying true to our divine missions of promoting self-empowerment, and the conviction that it's we ourselves who must take control and responsibility to ensure our own survival, we stand in our absolute power as architects of destiny, innovatively reshaping and constructing the very surroundings and conditions of the environment in which we operate. The spiritual essence, magnetic allure, and energetic strength of our ancestors remain with us always. In recognition of the sources of our divine gifts and the benefits and rewards that we receive from them, it is always a kind and loving gesture to utilize our special abilities in service of others, as well as acknowledging and honoring our ancestral guides through expressions of our endless appreciation and infinite gratitude.
Grandma Tane clapped in church on Sunday morning. Grandma played a tambourine so well. Grandma Tane used to issue out a warning. She'd say, Billy, don't you run so fast, might fall on a piece of glass, might be snakes there in that grass. Grandma Tane, Grandma Tane used to hand me piece of candy. Grandma's hand picked me up each time I fell. Grandma's hands, boy, they really came in handy. She'd say,
Matty, don't you whip that boy. What you wanna spank him for? He didn't drop no apple core, but I don't have grandma anymore. If I get to heaven, I'll look for grandma. That's the kind of grandmother I had. We gotta go, huh?
Oh, yeah. Time to go.
If I say that.